And it is Water Cooler Wednesday.
Yes, it is. Here today, Grizzlies television announcer Pete Pranica, Myron Mays with the What's Happening Myron radio show, and our own Todd Demers. Gentlemen, good to have you here.
Good morning.
Good to have you. Okay, so a 9-year-old reporter, 9 years old, you heard me right, is under fire this morning because she covers violent crimes in her Pennsylvania community. The little girl has her own website, and she posts videos with stand-ups just like a real reporter.
Now, the latest is about a murder, which she reported on from the active crime scene. Now, critics have lashed out that the girl urging her to play with dolls or to have a tea party, and they're attacking her parents as well for letting her do it. So, Pete, what do you think? Has she crossed the line or have the critics crossed the line?
A little bit of both. Number one, I applaud the fact that she wants to get into the business and she has taken an active interest in it. However, as a 9-year-old, I don't know that you are mature enough to wrap your mind around A, a murder, and B, this is also a domestic violence situation. Mm-hmm. I think she should continue to do her news gathering, but for her to investigate a murder, I think that's going a little bit too far, simply because she doesn't have, or no 9-year-old is going to have the emotional wherewithal to deal with that.
Mm-hmm. So the parents should have said, baby, let's stay with
vandalism and what's going on in the neighborhood, but okay, let's stay away from a murder.
So Myron, you've raised a couple kids.
Yeah, and now it's got me thinking. I should have started them all out a little bit sooner and everything. Because, I mean, at this rate, she'll be out of her parents' house this time next year.
She's already in the basement.
So. Exactly. But I applaud her. And for her to want to, you know, take on something like that, you know, I definitely, you know, give her a thumbs up and everything, too. So she's going to be a great reporter.
So, Todd, what about those who say she ought to be playing with dolls? She ought to be having a tea party. Can you believe that?
I think the critics need to leave her alone. I agree with Pete, though. I think murder's a little bit too much, and you may not have the tools to deal with that effectively. And I'm kind of surprised the parents didn't reel her in a little bit and say, you know, this is great, but let's not go there just quite yet. Let's stick a little bit closer to home, cover some other things, maybe not as tragic, and then we'll work it up from there. But she's awfully young to be dealing with murder.
But as a parent of young girls, don't you wonder, 9 years old, tea parties, dolls? They don't know 9-year-olds.
I like to be supportive, but at some point you got to say, okay, I'm going to support you up to right here.
All right. Well, a man who allegedly stole $31 worth of candy bars could get 20 years to life in prison. It's because he has 10 prior offenses, 5 for theft, and that allows the state of Louisiana to charge him with a felony in the candy bar case. Okay, Myron, what do you think?
Yeah, I have a sweet tooth, unfortunately, but it's not quite that bad.
So with this long history, is it still too much, 20 years?
Yes. Definitely. I mean, for candy bars, yes. And definitely there should be, you know, some type of intervention or something.
Well, I know
counseling,
there's not or something.
Intervention for candy bars, but, you know, there's got to be some type of, you know, help that he can get.
Intervention for sticky fingers, really.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it'd be exactly. Also interesting to see what the previous thefts and the previous convictions were for, because when you look at it as a package as a whole, as opposed to just the one candy bar crime, that 20 years may be necessary to get this guy back. Not that he's going to spend 20 years in jail, but at least something to get him on the straight and narrow to say, we're very serious about this, and you've got a long history of theft, and we've got to nip this in the bud somehow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think the thefts were like $500. So, I mean, you're investing thousands and thousands of dollars to run this guy through the legal system, incarcerate him for 20 years. Mm-hmm. The state's spending untold thousands, if not millions of dollars over petty theft. I think that there's got to be some common sense. I understand that the law enforcement and the legal system wants to make sure you don't have repeat offenders, but this is taking it too far.
All right.
Okay.
And listen to this. A nurse in Texas ordered a pizza during his graveyard shift in the hospital, but got more than he paid for. The pizza came with a note that said, quote, "We would appreciate it very much if you didn't wait until 5 minutes before we close." Our question is not whether sending the note was out of line. I'm sure we all agree it possibly was. But does the pizza employee have a point? Is it rude to walk into a business, or in this case, call one right before closing time when you know you can't get the service you require by the time it closes?
Todd.
You know, that's a tough one, because why do you have hours that say you're open until such and such a time if that becomes an arbitrary number about 10 to 15 minutes before closing time. I would like to think that if you go in someplace, regardless of the time, they'd be honest enough to say, look, we've already shut down everything. I'm sorry, you know, it's like 5 till we've already closed. Or, you know, this is what we have left. This is what we still have open. It's like, why do we have these times if we're really not going to enforce them?
Good
point.
Now, I agree with Todd. The other thing, too, is you have to, again, use some common sense. This is a nurse. Who knows? They may be saving somebody's life, and they're really hungry. It's like,
and couldn't
wait, call in.
And
couldn't. I mean, sometimes people get stuck in traffic. There are a number of mitigating circumstances. But I agree with Todd. If you're open till 9, do you say, okay, we're going to take our last order at 8:45? If you're going to do that, then you need to post it and say, you know, sorry, we're open till 9, but we're taking our last phone order at 8:45 or something, so that you don't have these types of situations.
Okay.
Exactly. What's the last 5 minutes for a random conversation?
Yeah.
You know,
mm-hmm.
just drop by. But
have you ever worked in a restaurant? That's exactly what it's for.
I would not want to. I wouldn't want the pizza after the note has been put on it. So, you know, I'm thinking that, okay.
They weren't very happy about it.
They're angry at me. Yeah. I probably don't want to eat this pizza.
All right, gentlemen, thank you very much.
I love it.
Appreciate it.